Hello everyone. In this section, we will discuss about the further details of real-time operating system. We have discussed earlier some important concepts. So, how to handle interrupts while we are using a real-time operating environment? An interrupt is a program within the computer itself. An interrupt can be a program within the computer itself, or it can be a signal from a device which is attached to a computer. So we can say that an interrupt provides real-time behavior to the system. By doing like this, the interrupt informs the processor about the external devices which requires immediate attention, which is actually done by the CPU of the system. There are two types of interrupts, synchronous and asynchronous interrupts. Synchronous interrupts always occurs in synchronous with the currently executing task, whereas asynchronous interrupts occur in synchronous with the currently executing task. So a synchronous interrupt will occur in accordance with the currently executing task, while an asynchronous interrupt will not occur in accordance with the currently executing task. Okay, there are certain design principles that has to be taken care of while selecting a particular real-time operating system. The first parameter is the designing of interrupt service routines and tasks. Interrupt service routine is nothing, it is a small program which actually exists within a particular program. Embedded systems generally generate the interrupt. Okay, so according to the nature of the interrupt, that is, the interrupt can be masked and non-masked. If the interrupt is not masked, the system will save the current process and execute the interrupt service routine. So if the interrupt occurring is not masked, the ISR will be executed. Okay, so the interrupt are masked by using disable interrupt command and unmasked by using enable interrupt command. So among the design principles, the first point is whether the interrupts are masked or it is not masked. Depending upon that, the further procedure will continue. The second point is, each ISR design should be consisting of a shorter code. ISR is interrupt service routine, is actually a program which occurs in within another program, so that a particular program should be shorter, so it can be executed much easily. The next point is, design in the form of task for better and predictable response time control. When we consider the real-time operating system, the response time control is an important parameter. Actually, the system is designed upon a particular response time control. So the deadlines of the system should be met accurately. So for that, the response time control should be predictable. Then a modular design can be used. Since real-time operating systems are based on task scheduling, more than one task are executed at one time, so parallel execution of tasks are done. This is actually done by using a particular task scheduler. Task scheduler is nothing, it is a particular algorithm or a logic by which the task can be, multiple tasks can be executed at the same time. So modular design are preferred for real-time operating system. Then data encapsulation can be used. Data encapsulation is nothing but it ensures the security of the data. It binds the data together and it prevents the interference from the external devices, so the data will be safe. So modular design and data encapsulation should be taken care of. Then designing with taking care of time spent in system calls. So when there is more number of tasks, the time can be allocated, particular duration of time can be allocated for all tasks. So it is actually known as time slicing. So if you are having task T1 and T2, particular time will be allocated for T1. It should be completed within that time slot T1. Then the next task can be completed. Then design with using interrupt service threads or task. So while real-time operating system considers the interrupt, there are two cases. One, it will consider it as a fast level ISR, or it will consider it as a slow level IST. ISR means interrupt service routine, and IST means interrupt service thread. Okay, so ISR is always given priority over IST. So when the scheduler or the real-time operating system executes a particular task, the initial state is known as start state or idle state, and the final state is known as finish state. So the task the task will be executed with the help of an infinite loop like arrangement, so that it will start from idle state and it will go up to last state. Okay, in between the task will never terminate. Okay, the loop will start and the loop will complete. The number of tasks should be limited so that we can keep the response time of the end check. Okay, particular assignment strategy or preemption can be used. Preemption is nothing. Preemption means only limited time will be allocated for that particular task by the CPU. There are two types of task: preemptive task and non-preemptive task. While we consider preemptive cases, only limited amount of time will be allocated to complete the task by the CPU. If the task is non-preemptive, it can take another available time. So we can use preemption in the case of real-time operating system, so that a task can be completed in a particular duration of time or particular time slice. So the next time slice can be used for executing the next task. Avoid task deletion. Okay, once a task has started to execute, till it termination, avoid deleting it, because it takes up much time, and one of the fact is that it will provide additional memory space, but no other advantages are possible. Use idle CPU time for interval function. When the central processing unit of the system is not running in a task, it can be used for doing other work, such as reading the internal queue, managing the memory, search for free block of memory, delete the task, etc. Queue is nothing, it is an arrangement where the task can be kept before its execution. Design with memory allocation and deallocation by the task, then taking care of shared resource of data. Design with hierarchical and scalable limited RTOS functions. These 15 points are actually taken to be considered while designing a real-time operating system. So data encapsulation, multiple task execution, then response time control, avoiding task deletion, then using the idle time of the CPU properly are the important strategies to maintain to design a very efficient real-time operating system. Okay, then we know what a task is. A task is same as a process. It is a particular program which is to be executed by the system. It is also known as a process. So when there are more than one number of tasks, it has to be executed accurately. So multiple tasking or parallel tasking can be used. So it is actually known as process scheduling or task scheduling. It is the process of determining which task or a process is to be executed at a given point of time. It is somewhat similar to multitasking. Okay, so there are certain steps involved while a task is being executed by a real-time operating system, such as ready state from running state, blocked or wait state from running state. So initial state is ready state, then running state, then if there are chances of blocked or wait state, then ready state from blocked or wait state, then completed state. Each of these states can be classified as preemptive, non-preemptive or cooperative. Okay, I have already discussed that preemptive, the term preemptive means that it is limited. It has got only limited access to the CPU. Once we say that a task is preemptive, the task has got only limited access to the CPU. The CPU will be allocated for only a limited amount of time. So while selecting a particular task scheduling algorithm or a task scheduler, some factors has to be taken care of, such as CPU utilization, throughput, turnaround time, waiting time, response time. Throughput is nothing, it is defined as the number of processes executed per unit time. It should be high. Turnaround time defines the amount of time taken by a process for completing its execution, while waiting time defines the amount of time spent by a process in the ready queue. It should be minimal. And response time defines the time elapsed between the submission of a process and the first process. It should be also minimal. So So these all factors has to be taken care while selecting a particular task scheduler or a task scheduling algorithm. Our main objective is to execute more than one number of tasks or multiple tasking. For that, a good efficient task scheduling algorithm should be selected based upon these parameters. Then there is a particular term known as queue. There are three types of queue: job queue, ready queue, device queue. Job queue contains all the process in the system. It is a particular sort of arrangement. So job queue contains all the process in the system. Ready queue contains all the process which are ready for execution and waiting for CPU to get their return for execution. So in ready queue, the task or processes will be kept which are actually going to be initiated for execution. Then device queue contains set of process which are waiting for an input output device. Okay, so in this section we have discussed about the designing principles that we should take care while selecting a particular real-time operating system, and the concept of task scheduling. What is task scheduling? What all factors has to be taken care while scheduling a particular task or using a particular task scheduler algorithm. Okay, and what is the concept of queue? Job queue, ready queue, and device queue. The coming sections are based upon the different types of task scheduling methods. Actually, there are two methods: non-preemptive scheduling and preemptive scheduling, that we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.